Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. Another one of our Fordhams. Labels coming off here. I kind of like that though, it's a little bit more personalised almost. Almost as if the brewer's stuck them on himself. Right, I'm going to go round, and this is a Doppelbock. Now, Bock's one of these kind of a strange term, it's like a bit ambiguous. It's a good word for me, isn't it? A bit ambiguous as to its kind of actual translation, but it more or less means strong. Kind of like the way that our old English stout, the term stout means strong, you know. Now, so Bock lager is a strong lager, Doppelbock is double strong. And it's a double strong lager, and that will be hopefully strong malt and strong ABV. It's 8% ABV, which is quite a whacker. And it's dark as well, so hopefully it's going to be malty as well. Because I've been so abused in the past by Popsy McLagers. And even some of those that ain't Popsy McLagers have too often missed the mark. And I've kind of found the word lager itself in the back of my head is synonymous with crap, you know. So I've got high hopes. I have had a few lagers that I have really, really enjoyed, and this is brewed to the Reinheitsgebot, which is a kind of purity laws, an old Bavarian purity law from the Kaiser Wilhelm. There's the Wilhelm the Fourth or so, I can't remember. There's the FO. Don't ask me why I'm laughing. Right, that's the FO. And, so it's brewed to purity laws, the old Bavarian purity laws, which meant that you couldn't add anything unless it was barley, water, yeast, and hops. And that was it. Those four things, nothing else, not even wheat or anything. Certainly no kind of E numbers and stuff like that. So away we go. I'm not sure what kind of conditioning we've got going on, because the problem with brown bottles is you can't see nothing, so I can't tell what's hiding in there. So I'm gonna have to pour it short, even though it's only a 355? What is 355? Why is that 355? We usually have 330s or 500s. Occasionally you'll get a British pint, which is, or an Imperial pint, which is 568 millilitres. But these are 355 millilitres. I'm pouring a lot in because it's really dark. And where they're kind of curvy edges on the bottle, I'm kind of taking that as an indication that it's not going to be holding a lot back. Usually when you've got edges like that, big shoulders on it, then you've got to be holding a lot back. And it has come out crystal. And there's no cladding on the bottom, so tip it up, get it in. It smells, even for me, this is a foot and a half away. It smells glorious. Oh, that's weird. You got something in there that's almost a kind of tea tree, almost like that kind of hospitaly sort of smell. But it's very, very pale and thin, so it's not to worry about. But you've also got some, you've got some lovely chocolate malt in there. You know that burnt toast thing you get from the chocolate malt? Those ones that I had, I was chewing and smelling and everything else. Have a look at me malts and hops video. You got those. You got a slight chocolate smell, a slight coffee smell. No, lovely burnt toast smells in there, though. And a very slight fruity sort of smell, kind of along the, as if you've, someone's used marmalade on a knife and then put it in the butter, you know, butter, and then buttered a bit, you've buttered your toast with it, you've got just a hint of marmalade, you know, yeah, people do that. Dirty sod. Right, bottoms up, chin chin. Oh, these every now and again you get one of these beers that I always find is a pleasant surprise. A lot of the brewers spend a lot of time making sure you've got lovely aromas as well. And that is really nice, but it's a kind of a lovely surprise when you kind of get the aromas and you're going, I'm not getting much there, and these little bits that I'm getting, you know, and a bit wafery and a bit kind of paper thin. And that's how that was on the nose. It was a little bit paper thin. It was nice, and you was getting certain odors and certain aromas, but on the taste, it's really going for it. Really going for it. Excuse me, slurping. You got big, thick toffee taste. You got molasses there, which is quite surprising how sweet it is, considering that it's Reinheitsgebot, you know, it's kind of purity brewed in that, you know, it's not using any sugars and stuff like that, and yet you'd swear there was molasses and muscovado sugar in there and stuff like that, you know. It's almost kind of almost running towards the kind of imperial stouts almost and things like that, you know. Oh wow, you got a big punching kick at the back, but it's not a kind of horrible alcohol kind of brash kick. It's a big malty, you know, growling sort of, you know, that one that growl that the lions do. It's kind of like that, you know, that big deep throated growl. It's just coming in at the back there, and that is lovely, that really is. If you're looking for, I don't go down the road of winter and summer beers, but if you're looking for a winter beer, this one is it. A Doppelbock there. American Dark Lager. Really superb drink. Oh, yeah, under the Bavarian Purity Law 1516. And it's the Bavarian, the Reinheitsgebot, it's the oldest kind of food or drink legislation that was kind of a law legislating the purity of what went into it. Excuse me, a bit gassy. People say about us burping in these, you try drinking in 10 minutes or so, drinking down, you know, a drink and talking, and drinking and talking. It's not easy. That is superb. That it really is superb. Right, without a doubt, guys, go and buy it. Buy it and try it. It's available, I believe, Owls by Mail. And probably Beers of Europe and a lot of the other guys out there. Do go and buy it and try it. It is an absolutely superb drink. It really is. And that's an American brew, I believe. Yep, from Delaware. From Dover. From Dover in Delaware. superb stuff. Without a doubt, buy it. Buy it and try it. Fordham's Brewery. Chin chin, bottoms up. Cheers.